In the currency quadrant today, looking at the euro futures contract over at the CME, the 6E, actually still the June contract we're looking at, and a wide trading range today, not as wide as yesterday, but it looks like a wide range given how we finished near the top of the range that we've been in since April and right around unchanged in toward the end of the day. We were up 33 basis points as we got to the highs today at about 110.34.5. That again was at the top of the range. Down on the lows, down about 55 basis points at around 109.37.5 on an open to close basis. We are now up 5 of the last 7 sessions. And again, that close today took us back near that top of the range that we've been in since early April. EU stimulus, largest news story for the European Union and for the euro currency, 750 billion euros of stimulus, about 826 billion US dollars, is being proposed. It is not approved yet, just was being proposed, and a lot has to go through Germany first. Not sure if Germany's going to be good with that yet. So we got to be careful about assuming this is a done deal. And when looked at in the context of what the United States has done in the trillions of dollars, not very impressive of a number. And that might be why the euro got that sell-off a little bit later and then that rally back toward the end of the day. Now, tomorrow, there's data that matters. So you're going to be looking again. EU's at the top of the range. Does it break out on tomorrow's data? We're looking at final EU consumer sentiment. We're looking at economic sentiment, industrial sentiment, and also German inflation data. That's all coming out tomorrow. So that will matter to if we get a breakout from this top of the April range. And then you'll want to look for a pullback and then a confirmation on the way back up to see if the euro is going to have a sustained move above 110.